Hello students, welcome to Don Bosco PU College online classes. We are trying our best to make teaching learning experience easy to our students. So subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to never miss any update.
Good morning dear students. This is Shafi from Don Bosco PU College, Chitradurga. I hope everyone is fine at your home. Here we are going to discuss about the second PUC preparatory examination of 2020 and 21. This exam was held in our college. So in this class, let us solve this question paper. See the first question. I think everyone has a question paper. You just see the question paper. See the first question. Define onto function. What is meant by onto function? Onto function is nothing but a function f from a to b is said to be onto. A function f from a to b is said to be onto. Every element of the set b has at least one pre-image of the set a. Is called onto function. Every element in the codomain has at least one pre-image in the domain is called onto, or else onto function is also can be written as range is also equals to codomain. Codomain and range both are equal. It is the definition of onto function. Once again I will repeat. A function f from a to b is said to be onto. Every element in the set b has one and only one. Every element in the domain b, every element in the set b has at least one pre-image in the set a is called onto function, where range and codomain must be equal. Next, it is what onto function. See the second question. Second question, what is the domain of cos inverse x? Domain of cos inverse x, I already told you in the inverse trigonometric chapter. The domain of cos inverse x is minus 1 to 1. It is the domain. Next, see the third question. So these are the two direct questions. No need more explanation. See the third question. Construct 2 by 2 matrix whose elements are given by Aij equals to I divided by j. So given that Aij equals to I divided by j, we have to construct 2 by 2 matrix. So we have to construct 2 by 2 matrix so that we need to construct a 2 by 2 matrix that A equals to A11, A12, A21, A22, right? We have to construct 2 by 2 matrix. We need to find the elements A11, A12, A21, A22. So let us find out. A11 equals to Aij is I divided by j 1 by 1 equals to 1. It is A11. What about A12? 1 by 2. 1 divided by 2. Yes, it is enough. 1 divided by 2. Next, A21 equals to 2 by 1. It is 2. Next, A22 equals to 2 by 2. That is equals to 1. 2, 2 will get cancelled. 1. Now, we have to construct, which means you have to substitute the values of A11, A12, A21, A22. Therefore, the required matrix A equals to A11 is 1. A12 is 1 by 2. Next, A21 is 2. A22 is 1. It is the required matrix. Now, we have constructed the matrix 1, 1 by 2, 2 and 1. Next, see the fourth question. If A, the matrix A equals to 1, 2, 4, 2. Then find the determinant of 2a. We need to find the determinant of 2a. For this question, first we need to find the matrix 2 into A. 2 into A equals to 2 into A. Matrix is what? 1, 2, 4, 2. That is equals to 2 into 1 is 2. 2 into 2 is 4. 2 into 4 is 8. 2 into 2 is 4. It is a matrix 2A. Next, we need to find the determinant of 2A. Determinant of 2A. You see the question paper, you will get idea. Determinant of 2A is what? Matrix of 2A is 2, 4, 8, 4. Determinant. How to find determinant? 2 into 4 is 8 minus 4 into 8 is 32. That is equals to minus 24. Therefore, determinant of 2A is minus 24. It is the fourth question. Next, see the fifth question. See the fifth question. Differentiate cos of sin x with respect to x. Let us consider it will be y. We need to find dy by dx. Differentiate both sides with respect to x. Then what we will get? Dy by dx equals to differentiation of cos is minus sin of sin x. Again, we need to differentiate sin x. Sin x is cos x. It is the differentiation of cos of sin x is minus sin of sin x into cos x. Next, see the sixth question. In sixth question, we have integration of secant of secant x plus tan x into dx. Let us integrate equals to, now you multiply this secant x. Multiply this secant x inside the bracket. Secant x into secant x is secant square x plus secant x into tan x is secant x tan x into dx. Next, integration of, that is equals to integration of secant square x is tan x plus integration of secant x tan x is secant x plus c. It is the integration. Next, see the seventh question. Define coplanar vectors. So coplanar vectors are, it is the definition of coplanar vectors. It is a question, direct question. I think you no need more explanation about this definition. If all the vectors are in the same plane, are called coplanar vectors. If all the vectors are in the same plane, suppose you just imagine we have a one plane. All these are the vectors lies in the same plane are called coplanar vectors. It is the definition of coplanar vectors. Once again, I will repeat. If all the vectors are in the same plane are called coplanar vectors. It is seventh question. Next, eighth question. If a line makes angles 90 degrees, next 135 degrees, next 45 degrees with x, y, z axis respectively, then find its directional cosines. So for this question, you need to remember the formula for directional cosines. In three-dimensional geometry, we will have the formulas for finding directional cosines. So directional cosines are denoted by L, M, N. If the angles is given, we need to take directional cosines as cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma. If we don't know the angles, then we need to apply some other formula for finding the directional cosines. For this question, we need to apply the formula cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma. Here given alpha 90 degrees, beta 135 degrees, gamma 45 degrees. So direction cosines we need to find. Let us apply cos alpha. Cos alpha equals to cos 90. Next, cos beta is cos 135 degrees. Cos gamma, cos 45 degrees. Find the values of cos 90, cos 135, cos 45. Cos 90 degrees. Cos 90 is how much? Yes, we know cos 90 is 0. Then cos 135 degrees. This also can be written as cos of 180 minus 45. 180 minus 45 is 135 degrees. So 180 minus theta, which lies in second quadrant. In second quadrant, cos is negative, minus cos 45. Minus cos 45 is 1 by root 2. Next, cos 45 is 1 by root 2. Therefore, the directional cosines are, write the conclusion. Therefore, directional cosines are 0, minus 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. So these are the directional cosines. Next, see the ninth question. Ninth question is also a direct question. No need more explanation. Define optimal feasible solution. Optimal feasible solution. Yes, define optimal feasible solution is nothing but any point in the feasible region that gives the optimal value of the objective function is called optimal solution. Once again, I will repeat, any point in the feasible region that gives the optimal value of the objective function is called optimal solution. It is a direct question. You don't need many more explanation about this definition. You have to learn the definitions. Next, see the 10th question. P of A, 6 by 11. P of B, 5 by 11. And P of A union B is 1 by 11. Then find P of A intersection B. We need to find P of A intersection B. For that, we will have one formula. P of A intersection B equals to, so P of A intersection B, we have to find P of A intersection B formula. P of A plus P of B minus P of A union B. That is equals to P of A, 6 by 11. P of B, 5 by 11. P of A union B is 1 by 11. LCM of 11, 11, 11 is 11 only. 6 plus 5 minus 1. Final answer will be 6 plus 5 is 11. 11 minus 1 is 10. 10 by 11 is the answer. Hence, these are the solutions for the 1 mark questions. Next, we will move on to the 2 marks. See the 11th question of the question paper. Verify whether the operation star defined on Q by A star B equals to AB by 4 is associative or not. We need to verify this operation is associative or not. You have to remember the property of associative. Associative property is what? A star B star C equals to A star B star C equals to A star B star C. So you need to apply that property. Let us apply. Associative property is A star B star C equals to A star B star C. It is a associative property. this property you need to remember. Next, see LHS equals to LHS A star B star C. So A star B star C equals to A star B. A star B is what? AB by 4 star C equals to, next again apply A star B. So A star B is AB by 4. A star B in place of A, in place of A we have AB by 4, in place of B we have C. Apply once again A star B. So AB by 4, AB by 4, AB by 4, A in place of A we have AB by 4, AB by 4, in place of B we have C. Therefore that is equals to ABC divided by 4 into 4 is 16. It is LHS. Next, verify RHS 1. RHS A star B star C. That is equals to A star B is AB by 4. What about B star C? BC by 4. That is equals to, again apply A star B. In place of A we have A only. In place of B we have BC by 4. Apply A star B. A star B is AB by 4. AB by 4. In place of A we have A only. Write A. In place of B we have BC by 4. BC by 4. If we simplify, finally we will get ABC by 4. Yes, LHS and RHS both are equal. Therefore, LHS equals to RHS. Hence, star is associative. Hence, star is associative. It is the 11th question. Next, see the 12th question. See the 12th one. Evaluate tan inverse root 3 minus secant inverse minus 2. So tan inverse root 3 minus secant inverse minus 2. So secant inverse minus 2, we will have one property. Secant inverse minus 2, we have one property. Secant inverse of minus x equals to pi minus secant inverse x. These properties are deleted from your syllabus. If we use this property, you find very easy to simplify this question. So that I am using this property. So secant inverse of minus x is pi minus secant inverse x. Secant inverse of minus 2 is what? Pi minus secant inverse 2. That is equals to tan inverse root 3. So tan inverse root 3, tan of which angle is root 3? Tan inverse root 3, you write as it is. In the next step we will simplify. Here we have minus, let us simplify. Minus into minus, minus into pi is minus pi, minus into minus is plus secant inverse 2. That is equals to secant tan inverse of root 3. So tan inverse of root 3, tan of which angle is root 3? Pi by 3 minus pi plus secant inverse 2. Secant of which angle is 2? Pi by 3. That is equals to LCM is 3, pi minus 3 pi plus pi. That is equals to pi plus pi is 2 pi, 2 pi minus 3 pi is minus pi by 3. Hence it is the solution for the 12th question. See the 13th question. See the 13th question. Find the area of the triangle whose vertices are by using the determinants. So we need to find the area of a triangle by using the determinants. Determinants A equals to 1 by 2 into determinant of x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. Next, 1, 1, 1. This is what we have to write like this. Now, x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. Those are the points. You just substitute 1 by 2 into determinant of x1, y1. See the points in the 13th question. 3, 8. So, 3, 8. Next, second point, -4, 2. -4, 2. Next, third point, 5, 1. Here, you just write 1, 1, 1. Simplify by using the determinants, 1 by 2 into. I think you will have an idea to find the determinants. Plus, minus, plus. First, we need to write plus as it is. Next, delete first row, delete that corresponding row and column. 2 into 1 is 2, minus 1 into 1 is 1. Next, minus 8 into, delete that corresponding row and column. Minus 4 into 1 is minus 4, minus 1 into 5 is minus 5. Plus 1 into, delete that corresponding row and column. Minus 4 into 1 is minus 4, minus 2 into 5 is 10. These type of questions, I think you have practiced so many times. That is equals to 1 by 2 into 3 into, find the determinants, 3 into, 2 into 1 is 2, minus 1 into 1 is 1, minus 8 into, delete that corresponding row and column, minus 4, minus 5. Next, plus 1 into, delete that corresponding row and column, minus 4 into 1 is minus 4, minus 2 into 5 is 10. Now simplify it, that is equals to 1 by 2 into, 2 into 1 is, sorry, 2 minus 1 is 1, 3 into 1 is 3 again, minus 4 minus 5 is minus 9, minus 9 into minus 8 is 72. Minus 4, minus 10 is minus 14. That is equals to 72 plus 3 is 75. 75 minus 14 is 61. 61 by 2 square units. Here it is a area of a triangle. Next, see the 14th question. See the 14th question, y equals to sine of tan inverse of e power minus x, find dy by dx. So we need to find the differentiation, differentiate with respect to x, then dy by dx equals to, differentiation of sine is what, cos of tan inverse of e power minus x into, again differentiation of tan inverse of e power minus x is 1 by 1 plus x square, so 1 plus x square in place of x, e power minus x whole square into, again differentiation of e power minus x is e power minus x into, differentiation of minus e power minus x is minus 1. Now, you just simplify it once again. Differentiation of sine is cos tan inverse of e power minus x, right, as it is. Again, differentiate tan inverse of e power minus x is 1 by 1 plus e power minus x whole square into, differentiation of e power minus x is e power minus x into minus 1. E power minus x into, differentiation of minus x is minus 1. That is equals to cos of tan inverse of e power minus x into, e power minus x into minus x is minus e power minus x divided by 1 plus e power minus minus x into 2 is minus x whole square. It is the differentiation of y. Next, see the 15th question now. So 15th question, this question I think you know already. Sine square x plus cos square y equals to 1. From this equation, first we need to differentiate, then we have to find dy by dx. Now differentiate with respect to y. Differentiate with respect to x. Differentiation of sine square x is 2 sine x into differentiation of sine square x is 2 sine x into differentiation of sine x is cos x plus differentiation of cos square y 2 cos y into differentiation of cos y is minus sine y into differentiation of y is dy by dx equals to differentiation of 1 is 0. Differentiation of sine square x 2 sine x into differentiation of sine x is cos x plus differentiation of cos square y 2 cos y into differentiation of cos y is minus sine y into dy by dx equals to 0. Now we need to find the dy by dx so that you send this, okay, you just simplify for the 2 sine x into cos x, so plus into minus is minus, 2 cos y into sine y into dy by dx equals to 0. Send this one to the right, then 2 sine x cos x equals to 2 into cos y into sine y into dy by dx. We need to find dy by dx. Send this to the left, then that will become 2 sine x cos x divided by 2 cos y into sine y equals to dy by dx. Here 2 will get cancelled. Finally dy by dx equals to sine x cos x divided by cos y sine y. Hence it is the solution for the 15th question. I understand. Next, we will move on to the next question. See the 16th question. If y equals to a sin x plus b cos x, then prove that d square y by dx square plus y equals to 0. First, you need to differentiate dy by dx equals to a into differentiation of sin x is cos x plus b into differentiation of cos x is minus sin x, that is equals to a cos x plus into minus is minus b into sin x. It is what? Dy by dx. Next, d square y by dx square. Differentiate. D square y by dx square equals to, for this again you can differentiate a cos x. A into differentiation of cos x is minus sin x minus b into differentiation of sin x is cos x. Therefore, that is equals to minus a sin x minus b cos x. It is what? D square y by dx square. Take this to the left, then that will be d square y by dx square. Then minus will become plus a sin x plus b cos x equals to 0. Next, this can be replaced as d square y by dx square. You just observe a sin x plus b cos x is also can be written as y is what? A sin x plus b cos x. You can take equation number 1. From equation 1, this can be written as y equals to 0 since it is from equation 1. Hence we proved. Are you understand? Okay dear students, it is the class for today. In the next video we will continue with the 17th question. Thank you.